Thank you very much. Dear friends and colleagues, thank you for the invitation. It's indeed quite important to continue this tradition of the Primakov readings. Evgeny Primakov was a great man, a great thinker, and practitioner. And this is important these days. I can hardly anything to add to the analysis of the world situation which Alexander just presented. The multipolarity which Primakov foresaw is being shaped in real life, in economy, in finances, in technologies, and of course with all this political influence comes as well. And countries who address those achievements, of course they would like to be more influential in the world arena. There is an attempt to stop or to slow down this process, the process of multipolarity being shaped. But these attempts only delay the outcome and delay a deal, if we speak about deals in this world. Statistics from the IMF shows that the GNP of BRICS countries is already bigger than the GNP of G7, and this trend is supposed to continue. So the option which we all have is to use this kind of gatherings, Primakov readings, or Munich conference, Chatham House, any political scientist gathering to assess the situation. There is another option, and here comes the second, one of the many other features of Primakov, Primakov being practitioner. What are we going to do about this? Listening to the debates at this conference, make a couple of conclusions. Alexander said that Mark Esper declared a new Cold War against China. Some others were saying that it is absolutely necessary for this conference to develop an approach to contain China, to respond to the Chinese challenge, to the Russian challenge, to contain either each of them separately or both of them at the same time. This discussion, as it is structured, including through the report of this conference, it is not intended to try to use this gathering of wise and experienced persons to develop some kind of recommendations to the track one, as it were. And I think that this is one of the deficiencies of these conferences, when people just would like to make some spectacular statements which will make headlines, but which will make no influence, no effect on the real relationship between the countries. Polycentric bipolarity, as Alexander described it, might be something in the offing. But we either watch this evolve, or we try to shape things slightly more constructively. And I don't have in mind any special initiative, but just to remind you that a couple of weeks ago in Jerusalem, President Putin proposed to think about a summit of P5. Not because this is an inclusive club, exceptional countries being together, but because they have, under the United Nations Charter, which, thank God, is still alive, they have special responsibility for anything which takes place in the area of international peace and security. And this proposal is on the table. It would be interesting to hear your views about this. I think I stop here, and with this I thank our friends from the media, and we apologize for not offering you some lunch.